Chapter 12. The Baron instructed his own men to place himself and his wife under arrest. Yield us only to the king. Thus, tied to their horses and accompanied by the castle guard, they, Longsword, Muggins, the queen, and the Princess Abigail made their way to the king's castle. In the great hall, the party were brought before the king. The story was told, and the king sat solemnly considering what to do. Finally, he rose and the room became silent.
Baron Blackheart.
Your Majesty.
I cannot find against you. You were unwitting in this plot. You played no part in it. Indeed, it was the goodness in you that allowed you to overcome the spell placed upon you by the magician. You are free to go.
Thank you, sire.
As to your wife...
Sire, if I may... interrupted Baron Blackheart. I appreciate my freedom, but if it be your intention to do with my wife something different to me, then I beg you to think again. I ask not that you spare her in any way the punishment you see fit, but that you award me the same fate. She was stricken by grief in the same way as we all were, but hers was the grief of not having rather than of losing. In its own way, it too was a spell, not that of a magician, but a spell of nature, and just as powerful, perhaps the more so.
Blackheart, you pain me,
groaned the king,
for I fear that she must sacrifice her life. Hers was a wickedness and a cunning such that yields the right to life.
My life is nothing without her, sire.
So be it.
The king addressed the soldiers behind him.
Take them to the gallows.
The nooses were fastened around the necks of the Baron and Baroness. They sat astride their own horses, which were held by the Baron's soldiers. The other side, whispered the Baron to his wife. I shall see you the other side of this life, and there we can hope for more. The horses fidgeted, snorting, wanting to move. The soldiers reined them back. I'm sorry, she whispered. I am so very, very sorry. The king raised his hand. The soldiers waited for it to fall. From the direction of Blackheart's castle, a blackbird flew, hovering above them, and then swooped down, settling on the gallows above the baron.
The crows always arrive early for a feast,
said the king.
Not a crow, your majesty, a blackbird,
said Muggins. The bird hopped onto the baron's shoulder and started to peck at the rope.
Wait!
Roared the king. He strode to the gallows and stretched his arm upwards. The blackbird frantically pecked at the rope, then stared into the king's eyes sadly. The king gazed at the bird, his eyes softening. He raised his hand slightly in warm invitation to the bird. Its head fussed from side to side, gave a last peck at the rope, and hopped onto the king's nearby hand.
Nature will drive all creatures to do strange things for our children,
muttered the king as he walked away. He stopped at the wall and looked up high into the sky as he set the blackbird free and watched it flying towards Castle Blackheart. He turned and bellowed,
Cut them loose!